Hello guys. Where does he find the energy? He's doing that all day. Okay, let's go see Buddy. Here's a big boy. Buddy! We were playing this morning. He was running around. Buddy! Ooh. 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 Mm, we like that. Oh, we like that. Buddy! Now, let's go inside. So guys, here we are. As you can see, all the yards are on. So today we're going to work with the sails. I'm going to do two videos for the sails, this one and one more. In today's video, we're going to throw on one of these and one of these. Also, the rear one. And in the next video, we're going to throw on the main yard, main mast, and one of the verticals. Each and every other sail are going to be similar with this one. Over here at the bow, each company places a different number of sails. For instance, Constructo placed 4. Artesana Latina has 2. Mantua has 3. Billing Boss has none, so I'm going to do that. If I'm not mistaken, Okre has also 2. I'm going to do that in the middle. I'm going to use Mantua's schematics and I'm going to place 3 here. I don't know yet where I'm going to place, but I will see the schematics and we'll do that together. Of course, I'm going to place 1 and I'm going to explain how to place the other 2 if you wish to place 2, 3, because you can always place 2. Or follow construction, constructor here and place 4. So let me get ready, have my schematics also ready, and I'll get back to you to continue. Probably going to start from the rear. Okay, let's begin with this one and then we'll go forward over to the bow. First of all, we need some thread. I'm not going to use the precious rope of scales. The thread we need usually is twice the size, the length of the yard, so approximately 2 times comes over to what I have cut. Now let me pass, use the tool for what it was made for. When you pass thread, you stitching the sails over to your yards, you must be very, 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 very careful not to mess around with the existing rigging. That is the most difficult part of all. So this must be careful not to make any damage. So I see that I should begin over here. Now, let me explain something. If you try to do the stitching like that, you will end up with a sail trying to get around the yard. So, that is wrong. We're going to do a specific type of stitching to make it right. I've seen many different ways to do the stitching over to the yards. If you find a way that suits your needs, be my guest. I prefer this one. It's much better for me, and also makes the sail to be straight over to the yard. I believe that here I have too many pulleys that I will end up removing them, but okay. Now, over to the other side. Let me remember. No, not like that. You see what I mean? No, over here. Under. This is what I meant when I was saying that it becomes a little bit difficult with all the rigging. Now, inside here and pull. But of course, I have to pull it over there. Let me check something, because the gravity is not helping me. Okay, just a drop of glue, make it a little bit higher, and a drop of glue to have the sail stay over there. As you can see, I have it flat. Now, let me do that all the way over here and I'll get back to you to continue. Got it. See the stitching? I got it in a straight line. Normally, over here, over to this part of the mast, we use some big rings that will go around the mast and inside the sail. Sorry for that. I don't have that kind of rings, and to tell you the truth, it's going to be a messy job to do that, so I'm going to leave it like it is. Maybe I will secure this piece over here, we'll see. Now let me see how this is attached and tied, and I will get back to you to do it. Okay, now we're going to tie this over here through this ring over to this pulley, down to this pulley, and we're going to tie it over here. So this is going inside here. No need to make any knots, just a drop of glue, cut the excess, got it. Now let's calculate how much do we need. I believe this should be enough. Over here, through this pulley. Got it. Now, I'm going to tie this edge over here, over to the mast, so I won't have it moving around. Let me do that and I'll get back to you, because we have some more threads, some more ropes, sorry, to throw on over to this side. Now, this is going to be fun. We're going to have to throw on three different ropes. We have here a single pulley, a double pulley, a triple pulley. These pulleys are attaching to each other through the ropes. Let me get a piece of rope long enough. Of course I'm using rope of scales, 0.45, done. Now, it's best, sorry guys, give me a moment to check something. All right, it's best to start from top. So here we're going to use the top hole. As you can see, I'm making them a little bit with a 90 degrees corner. Again, top hole. Now it's single hole. And now this is going over here. Be careful not to mess around with the rigging. Now let's pull it a little bit, just a drop of glue to secure everything. And that's that. Now this is going to be attached down here. I'm going to do that later. Leave it over here for the moment. Now to go for the next one. Second hole. The other hole here. And around here. Now the third one. One hole left. Down here. Now let me attach them all three over there and I'll get back to you. Got it. Now let me turn the zipper out and we'll move over to the bow. Again we're going to do the stitching the same exact way. Usually it's 2.5 to 3 times the length over here. I need my needle, give me a moment. Okay. Now again, be very, very careful about the rigging that already exists. Because it's very easy to mess up with. And you will make a beautiful knot. Let's calculate. Beautiful. Just a drop of glue to secure it here and not have it moving around. Now, again, over here. Over here goes through the loop we made. See what I mean? There's a mistake. This is a mistake. So you can easily make nuts. Oh boy, okay. Remove the needle. It can be, it is very easy to make a mess over here. Because of the existing rigging. One wrong pass, and you have a beautiful nut. Now over here. Above, inside, again inside the loop that I have made. You will get the chance to see that again when I do the main sails on. Don't worry about that. The technique is exactly the same. Now let me finish that because it will take some time, and I'll get back to you to continue. Okay, now let's put the rope here in the corner. It goes through here. Exactly the same technique as before. Goes through that pulley over here. And now it's going to tie itself over here on the second or third, don't remember. But to do that, I have to turn the seabourn the other way. Let me do that. Now, we have to use two pulleys, one on each side. Oh boy, let me see how these are going to be attached. We use this pulley, as I can see. And we're going to attach it over here. I don't believe I have enough rope. No, let me get some rope. All right. Now we're using this one. This comes all the way over here and ties itself around the pulley. I have to do the same with the other side, but I will do that later. Now, let me check something. Now, we need some rope to fold the sail. This is going to be easy. Let me get some rope over here. Of course, everything that it is done in this side will be done on the other side as well. Okay, now let's use this pulley. Come on. This will be tied over here to the rail, and let's calculate how much we need. Okay. That should be enough. Now, this rope will go down. This doesn't need to be stretched. We'll go up again, come over here, and tie itself around the yard. Okay, it doesn't have to be stretched. Now, I'm going to do the same on the other side and we'll finish with this one. And I'll get back to you. And I'll get back to you to do this part here. Okay, let me show you where the three cells are going to be, because of the height and the angle, it's impossible to film the entire picture. One cell is going over here. Also, on the top, over here, I have a pulley. Once here I have a double pulley. One cell is going to be in this line, and one cell is going to be in one of these lines, probably on this one to be further on the other side, and because this line is a bit closer to this pulley that I have over here. Also, I have a pulley here and a pulley here. I don't know what this pulley is for. This is what I need. This is probably, this won't be needed. We will see. Now, the sail. The sail is this. Give me a moment. The sail is this. So the sail will be it's exactly the same. So doesn't make any difference. Both sides. So the sail will be over here in that height, let's say. Let's see if I have. Oh, yes, I have a bigger one. Here we have. So the sail will be here. On this height, and will be attached over here with some rings around the rope. So give me some time. These are the rings. I'm opening them. Also, I have attached a pulley on the top. Got it. Now we'll place four more. Let me do that. Now, this pulley must be attached to this pulley over here, and not over here, down here through this hole, up here through this hole, and down here, and ties over here. Let me do that. Now, next, I will tie this part over here through this pulley. And will be tied over here. Let me do that. And finally, I'm going to pass a rope through here. One side will be tied over here and the other on the other side. Let me do that and I'll get back to you. Got it. So we have three sails on. We have plenty more to throw on. Like I said, I'm going to throw on two more here. One is going over here and one is going over here. So we'll have three sails over to the bow. So this was the sails rigging phase one. We're going to make another video. It's going to be the final video of the series. Every other sail after the final video is going to be exactly the same as one that already you have seen, and then we will have the final, the video, the making of that will conclude the series, around 11 months of work, and it's going to be a very beautiful ship. Until our next video, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the super thanks ability, and I hope to see you all in our next and then in our final video. Take care.